everybody. This is Elizabeth with A World's Cup of Joe, Awaken Your Soul. I wanted to talk to you guys about leaks and triggers in the TF connection and what are some things to avoid while you are trying to learn how to balance this addictive energy that is so potent and literally is all consuming when you're in the throes of this connection. So some really big leaks for many people when they're going through a 3D separation, or even when they're in the connection, but maybe it's not as good as it could be. One of the biggest leaks is comparing stories. A lot of times you are fighting with this addictive energy and you're just trying to find anything to soothe yourself. So you start researching and researching and you find different groups or different people that are on the same journey as you, but you start comparing stories. This is huge for so many people because you'll hear other people manifesting, you'll hear about someone that has contacted someone else, and you start wondering, why has my person not reached out to me? And my best advice, stop comparing stories. Maybe even get off some of these groups. I know you are seeking them out to feel like you're not alone, because this is a very lonely journey when you are dealing with it in the thick of things. But comparing stories is a huge leak and it puts a lot of push energy out there. Another one that is a huge trigger for many is social media. Social media is huge because a lot of times you have third-party acquaintances or friends that you share with your other self. So you are seeing them, you are thinking about your other self, and you are triggered beyond belief, or you are seeing maybe a karmic. And for those of you that don't know what karmic is, maybe your other self is in a new relationship with someone. And that'll be a huge leak and trigger for you. Another one is love songs, or songs just in general, ones you may have listened to with your other self that now you hear on the radio, and you are immediately put back in that place of thinking about your person and leaking and pushing all over the place. Another trigger can often be things you would have watched with your other self. I know that was a trigger for me when I was going through my dark night. I couldn't even turn the TV on. I could not turn the TV on without thinking about my other self. It was huge for me because we spent a lot of time watching documentaries and the news together. So when he left and I saw the TV, anything that would come on, I would think about him, and I couldn't do it. So I think it was, gosh, it was probably like 5 months before I watched TV again. Going places that you were with your other self with. Basically, a leak is going to be anything that's going to make you think about your other person that is going to bring up that addictive energy. You want to, this journey not only is about finding yourself, living your best life, and uncovering, remembering who you are, it is about learning how to balance your energy. That's where your other self comes in. They bring out this energy within, since that's what this connection is. It's an energetic one. And your whole thing is learning how to balance this energy. A lot of times, triggers before our other selves were from childhood, from, you know, wounds that, internal wounds that we had been carrying with for so long. And our other self, when we meet them, helps us sort of release some of those childhood triggers. But in meeting them, we come up with a whole new set of triggers that they uncover within us. And we are learning how to balance and navigate this energy that is so dominant once we have self-recognition. My best advice, because this is such a hard journey, Joanne and I created a 30-day detox. It is specifically to help you in your ascension. It is to help you learn how to manage this addictive energy that is so strong and so consuming. And it is to help you start living your best life. It is to help you realize that this connection is a gift and a blessing, despite it feeling like a curse when you're in the middle of your dark night and you are learning how to balance. It is not a curse. It is a beautiful, beautiful gift once you know how to balance the energy. So check out our site. We are having our final days of a sale on our detox, because we really wanted to gift you in the new year and this holiday season an opportunity to try it out. We've had amazing success with clients who have tried it. So check it out. Love you guys. Once again, this is Elizabeth with World's Cup of Joe. Awaken your soul.